Ex-Philippine President Duterte defends his former economic advisor from allegations of involvement in the illegal drug trade. Duterte also attempts to backtrack from his earlier statements, taking accountability for his war on drugs. Jeffrey Hernaez tells us more.
Philippine lawmaker Jervin Luistro believes that the Duterte administration's drug war lacked due process, particularly in the death of alleged drug personalities. Luistro argues the number proved this with drug war deaths reaching over 30,000.
If indeed they follow the requirement of due process, wala po dapat ganito karaming patay. At ang dapat maraming kaso na pending in court.
Luistro believes the mega panel is ready to file cases in court following the testimony of the former president, which would be considered an extrajudicial confession.
That the Quadcom is ready to make a recommendation for the filing of the necessary action in court, considering your statement of taking full legal responsibility, both to legal and illegal activities. Can I equate this statement of yours to an extrajudicial confession of guilt?
Well, in a sense, yes. Wala na akong magawa eh.
Are you saying yes, Mr. President?
Yes, because I ordered the campaign against the drug.
Duterte, however, walked back his statements when pressed about his claims taking full responsibility for his anti-drug campaign.
It is not a confession, it is a statement coming from the mouth of a mayor or a president at that time. It is not a confession.
Duterte also defended his former economic advisor, Michael Yang, who has been linked to the illegal drug trade and allegedly ties to a criminal syndicate.
Ang postura po ng dating Pangulo ay staunch enemy of illegal drugs. Pero malalaman natin, Mr. Chair, na ganun pala ang ilan sa mga aktibidad ng kanyang economic advisor. We had lots of evidence po dito sa hearings sa Kamara.
Produce one now.
The records of the House of Representatives can suffice.
Another lawmaker also grilled Duterte over his relationship with the Chinese national Yang.
Kung may ebidensya po tayo na involved siya sa droga, papatayin niyo rin po si Michael Yang?
Ako? Maniwala ka?
Kung may mga ebidensya
po,
papatayin niyo.
Tawagan kita, kasama.
Duterte was also grilled about the deaths of Chinese prisoners at the Davao Penal Colony. He denied any knowledge of the incident.
May nangyari pong patayan noong August 13, 2016. Sa Davao Penal Colony. After the killing, according to sa supplemental affidavit of Colonel Jerry Padilla, nung papalabas na po sila, nakaposas na po yung Chinese prisoners. According to Colonel Jerry Padilla, he received a call from New Dao congratulating him doon sa namatay na tatlong Chinese. And sinabi pa raw noon ninyo, a job well done.
Hindi ko kilala yung tao. I would never talk to a stranger.
Meanwhile, tension was high between Duterte and former Senator Laila De Lima when lawmakers asked about De Lima's investigation when she was head of the Commission of Human Rights.
Who investigated?
Panahon po ni Chairman Laila De Lima sa Commission on Human Rights.
Sorry, I do not know her.
Pakaraming mga okasyon, mga public pronouncements niya na ako ay tinitira niya, ako ay binabastos niya. Kung ano-ano yung mga sinasabi niya sa akin, binabantaan pa rin, binabantaan din ako. You will rot in jail, Laila De Lima.
At one point, Duterte was in making a threatening gesture against De Lima. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.